by slowly removing the window curtain of rain clouds and pushing her head a little outside. The lonely star in the western sky asked me, "Do you know me?" By blowing the fire and having the sparks from the hearth stuck up to the face, and sweating profusely as if had a shower bath, the star asked me, "Do you know me?" Coming out to the veranda of sunset, slowly wiping the face with a small towel, flapping the eyelids so often, and of course flashing sweet smiles, the star asked me, "Do you know me?" By touching and fondling the lovely little flowers bloomed on the plants grown in my balcony, I requested her, "Let me see your forefinger of right hand. Let me examine whether it has still the coolness it had while applying the herbal paste on my forehead, burning with a high fever. Let me see your hands, legs, the mid portion. And the bleeding cuts, and verify that whether you still have the imprints of male arrogance left on you, unerased and unfaded." "Yes, I know you intimately. I still remember that face attempting to smile with those broken teeth, even while a fire was blazing madly within you. I still hear the rhythm of your heart and beating, to which heart beatings. I still hear the rhythm of your heart beatings, to which you used to grasp me so close. Yes, I remember your soft movements, the coolness of your, of the flow of your intense love, as well as the glitter that appears and vanishes in your eyes so hastily, and the embers scattered from you once a while. Yes, I do remember you. Please come down and wipe my downcast face with the corner of your lower cloth, and once again fondle me as you used to do quite often."